I always tell people that if organs grew on trees, they would all look alike and have the same story. However, this is not the case. Every organ has a story and risks associated with it. A large part of our job is to assess organs and decide which risks are acceptable. Any liver we offer to you, we feel is safe to use. I'm going to explain some of the characteristics of donors so that you'll have familiarity with the terms when you are called when an organ becomes available. A donor who is brain dead has been evaluated by a medical team and found to meet established criteria for brain death. The way organs are recovered in this process allows the heart to remain beating and providing blood flow to the organs up until the moment of organ removal. This is in contrast to a heart death or DCD donor. In DCD donation, the decision has been made to withdraw life support on a donor and allow the heart to stop. When the life support is withdrawn, if the heart stops within a certain time frame, then we are able to utilize the organs for donation. Because of the way this process occurs, there is a period of time in which there is no blood flow to the organs. This increases the stress on the organs during the transition from donor to recipient. While the overall outcomes for brain dead and DCD donor livers are similar, this added stress during the transition period may result in a longer healing period and has an increased risk of scarring of the bile ducts. Split or partial liver transplant occurs in two situations. In living liver donation, about half of a donor liver is removed from the living donor and placed into you. This healthy piece of liver is large enough to meet your needs and will continue to regenerate over time. A second situation in which a piece of liver is used is in deceased donation. In deceased donation, if the first person on the waiting list does not need the entire liver, for example, if it is a small child, the remainder of the liver is offered to the next person on the waiting list. Regardless, if you receive a whole organ or a piece of an organ, your entire liver and gallbladder will be removed. All of our donors are tested extensively for infections. All of the donors test negative for hepatitis and HIV. These tests are very good, but they are not perfect, and so there is a very low risk of unintended infection. If there is concern regarding donor infection risk, this will be discussed with you. Because of this low risk of unintended infection with all donors, all liver transplant recipients are routinely tested for these viruses in the post-transplant period. Hepatitis B core antibody positive donors. This is a situation where the donor's blood work suggests a prior exposure or infection with hepatitis B, but they have no sign of active infection. If you receive this type of liver, you will need to take an extra pill along with your other post-transplant medications in order to prevent reactivation of the virus. Hepatitis C positive donors. In recent years, the medications to treat and cure hepatitis C have been revolutionized to a point that we are now able to transplant livers from donors with hepatitis C into people without hepatitis C. In this situation, the donor's blood work shows hepatitis C, but the liver does not show any sign of damage from the virus. Following transplant, you will be treated for hepatitis C. We typically begin this treatment within the first month after transplant. The treatment course lasts about 12 to 18 weeks and has a 96% cure rate after this single course of treatment.
I hope you have found this information useful today on this video. We hope to see you after the successful liver transplant, and we thank you for trusting our liver transplant team and the Henry Ford Transplant Institute with your care. I wish you the best of luck on your journey.